Please. My son needs me.
Mimir, not sure how to ask this. There are stories Odin told me, like how he lost his eye. Where the details are different from stories you've told me. And I trust you, of course, but they don't seem like things he'd have a reason to lie about either.
One thing to remember about liars, man. They lie. They do it on principle. No issue too big or too small. They lie about anything they can get away with and some things that they can't, just to demonstrate their power over reality. You must always bear that in mind.
If we go much further, we'll be right on top of the ogre. Better be sure we're ready.
We're fighting!
Yeah! I got that! Stop!
On your right!
Behind you! Okay!
Sod.
It went back to its perch. Let's go after it.
Son now.
Thank you. I can't wait to see his face again. I'll give him this gift and tell him about the brave people who helped me.
Now you can help us. What did you see that day?
A battle. unlike anything I've ever seen. I remember a great clash of metal in the sunlight. Thor, he wielded his hammer, but it was matched by a remarkable axe.
This axe? Did it belong to a fair-haired warrior?
Yes, that's the one. She brandished that axe with exacting precision. Strength. Never has there been a weapon to match Mjolnir. But with that axe, and that warrior, Thor was in for the fight of his life.
It was Faye who fought Thor.
It was more than just a fight. It sounds like Mom was beating... Thor.
It seems there is much I never knew about her. And now she is gone.
Maybe. But her story here isn't finished. Brother, about the oracles of your lands, would you say they manipulated events? Did they have an agenda?
I do not doubt they held their own interests first, but in my experience, they could be easily fooled by their own prophecies. But we will continue another time.
Lovely. Now you can open that gate without that ogre hurling detritus at us. Take it off, man! You've got this!
I saw Odin do something to some new Einherjar. He seemed kind of mindless until he cast the spell that restored their identity.
Aye, that was his habit, even when they were confined to Valhalla. I think letting them remember themselves was another small way of cheating death any way he could. Though I wouldn't be surprised if with that small gift of autonomy, he also embeds an undying personal loyalty to himself. Brother, what you said before about the oracles of your land being fooled by their own prophecies, I get the sense that was coming from personal experience, eh?
Yes. Once, I sought the oracle for a means to break my bondage to Ares. But we will speak of this later. Hmm.
pass open. That dragon is shaking in its scaly boots, I suspect.
Once we approach the dragon, we will kill or be killed. Understood?
Yes, Father.
Oh!
focus up!
That ogre's not getting up anytime soon either.
I can hear the animals. They're relieved. Maybe they'll come out of hiding.
There can't be many more dragons left now.
Then what are we waiting for? So, Father's new spear, it's made out of a ring?
Drop me an eye. Forged by the Vulture Brothers as a gift for Odin.
How's it work?
Every so often, the drop me or drips out identical copies of itself. The Huldras presumably figured that if one golden ring was a good gift, an infinite number of them would earn them a permanent place in Odin's heart.
Wait. Be ready for combat.
Out of here! Great flag!
It's gonna blow!
Huh.
discover? Can we get back to what you were saying about the Oracle of your homeland? You mentioned trying to escape your bondage to Ares.
Yes. One priestess had visions that showed her Olympus would be brought to ruin by the god of war. Therefore, she helped me, intending to undermine Ares and protect her realm. She did not foresee that I would kill him and take his office. In the end, I proved her vision of doom correct.
So the Oracle herself brought about the very future she hoped to avoid. I suppose we're in fine company at that.
Mimir, I know this sounds weird, but can you tell me again what happens when someone dies?
Every living thing has a soul, and every soul has four parts. Form, mind, direction, and luck. Direction steers the souls of giants, dwarves, elves, and animals toward the Lake of Souls in Alfheim, where all the parts may be absorbed back into Alfheim's great light. Another one of those mysterious crystals. There, that's got to be the last. To worry about.
You worry?
Oh, never while you're around, oh. Warrior of rippling muscle.
Mimir, you said souls come in four parts. Does that mean you can lose some of your soul, but not all of it?
Aye. Form, mind, direction, and luck. Lose any one of them, and the entire being suffers. Still, sometimes luck alone is enough. Just ask your father.
My success does not come from luck.
Ah, the refrain of the eternally lucky. Would have been a shame to have left that behind.
Hot blades coming up! Hot damn! Would these make for a painful way to go? Put some hurt on them. Let's make something then. Thirsty for blood before, you will be now. Need something special? Now, what else was there?
Enemy on the left!
Watch it!
Time to move!
Brother, somewhere out there there's a riddle you'd enjoy, and I'm going to find it.
Do not.
Once spoken, instantly broken. What am I?
Silence.
Correct!
I was not answering the riddle.
Ah.
Mimir, if I hadn't accidentally put Fenrir's soul into my knife, he would have gone to the Light of Alfheim when he died, right?
Aye. Were he a god or a human who died in battle, a Valkyrie would have taken him to Valhalla or Folkvanger. Had he been a human or god who died outside of battle, he'd been cast down to Helheim. But Fenrir was a wolf, so his soul would have joined all the others in Alfheim.
Like mothers.
Yes. Like your mothers.
Father, I wanted to ask you something about your blades. The ones from your homeland.
What of them?
Why don't you just throw them away? I see the way you look at them sometimes. Like you're... I don't know. Like you hate them.
Even hateful things have their uses. Besides, I tried. They came back.
How's the shield holding up, Black?
It's good. I always knew Sindri was a great blacksmith, but this magical shield, it just feels natural.
The shield is well made, but it is you who wields it with skill.
Thanks.
Brother, I've been meaning to ask. Your homeland. I'd heard the gods there wielded every flavor of power you could imagine. Lightning, fire, the whole lot.
As did I, for many years.
Whoa. Any chance you could recall some of that magic?
No. I have tried.
Freya said magic is bound to the earth. Your homeland died. Your powers probably won't live it.
Ah. Well, probably for the best. Let the past stay in the past and all that.
She's wounded. We can end this.
To her den?
Yes. Follow the blood.
I suspect this will lead us back to that den we came across.
Maybe once we get to her den, we can finally stop her.
Pity.
Do you admire her? She's terrorized this land, brother.
This jungle was her home. She defended it the way she knew. But if death is the only dignity we can give her, we will give it. Fresh blood.
Yes, we're getting closer.
More tracks here.
Let's see where they lead, brother. Curious, brother. Why don't you like riddles?
They are frivolous.
They encourage lateral thinking. Listen, there are three doors before you. One contains a pit of spikes, one a dragon, and one a pair of lions that haven't been fed in weeks. Which door do you open?
The first. A pit of spikes is easily avoided.
Ah, you should pick the third. Because lions that haven't been fed in weeks would be dead, eh?
I like this riddle.
To kill her.
Hey, Hamir.
Yes, lad?
You talk kind of funny.
Oh, how dare you, lad?
Go!
badly hit. You all right, brother?
Elka!
Tell me, any progress on finding my body and the other half of my stuff?
Ugh.
Father, why do I look like you?
In what way?
Like, bigger. And do I get muscles like yours?
When you work for them.
But Baldur was really strong, and he didn't have any muscles.
My strength does not come from my body, but both are honed by discipline.
What's that mean?
It means you've got the strength of a god no matter what, lad. But if you want the physique of one, you'd better start picking heavy things up and putting him back down.